This is All India Radio, Hyderabad. We now bring to you an interview with Mother Teresa, the recipient of the Bharat Ratna and the Nobel Prize, for her dedicated and selfless service in the cause of the poor and the downtrodden. She is interviewed by G.K. Marar.
Mother Teresa, affectionately called the Saint of the Slums, needs no introduction to our innumerable listeners. Going down memory lane, you started your mission of charity some 30 years ago, if I am correct, clad in a simple 4-rupee cotton sari with just 5 rupees in hand. The first to join your mission was your own student, a well-to-do Bengali girl, Subhashini. Now the missionaries of charity number about 1,800. How could you achieve this, Mother?
Because ours is a religious, is a spiritual body, and it is a vocation. And these numbers that have joined our society of the missionaries of charity, it is Christ who said that I have chosen you. By answering his call, we dedicate ourselves totally to him, to love him with undivided love in chastity, through freedom of poverty, in total surrender in obedience, and wholehearted free service to the poorest of the poor. And today, the young people are looking for a challenge. And the challenge is given to them where they can give up everything for the love of God in the service of the poor.
Nirmal Hriday is a place of peace, love and joy. Mother, you founded Nirmal Hriday to save people from dying on the streets. Along with medical care, what these men needed was moral support. To quote you, Mother, you told your sisters, touch the leper, touch him with love. A word about Nirmal Hriday, which you later converted into a leper center.
Nirmal Hriday is a part of the Kali temple in Kaligat. And in these 27 years, we have picked up from the streets of Calcutta 39,300 something. And out of them, out of that big number, more than 18,000 have died a most peaceful death. They have just gone home to God. And as so many of them, as especially one of them said, I have lived like an animal in the street, but I'm going to die like an angel, loved and care. Our people need just that, tender love and care, because they are Christ and the distressing disguise of the poor. And so, the more we do to them and for them, I believe that we are doing it to Jesus, who said, I was hungry and you gave me to eat. I was sick and you visited me. I was homeless and you took me in. I was naked and you clothed me. And in our Nirmal Hriday home and other homes around the world, we are just doing that. We are doing the work with Jesus, we are doing it for Jesus, and we are doing it to Jesus. And also, as Gandhiji has said, he who serves the poor serves God. So we are 24 hours in his presence.
Mother, you founded the Shishu Bhavan when you found a little baby abandoned in a dustbin. These homes are now all over the country. Mother, you have always managed one more bed for one more baby. How could you achieve this?
Because our sisters, all of us, take a vow to give wholehearted free service to the poorest of the poor. And by this vow, we depend fully and solely on divine providence. And divine providence takes care of us in a most extraordinary way that we have never had to send away anybody, because we didn't have. We don't have salaries, we don't have grants, we don't have maintenance of the church, we don't have anything that will bind us. Everything is given out of love and given to the poor with love.
A word about the Brothers of Charity, which you founded.
In 63, we started the Brothers, and they do the same work, and they are also called missionaries of charity. the same dedication, same complete surrender to God, with loving trust and with joy, they serve the poorest of the poor, and especially we are all together doing much work amongst the leprosy patients. In India alone, we have taken care of about 53,000 lepers, and with the help of government, we are creating in every state a rehabilitation center where we bring all the lepers, and the sisters or the brothers are the only one who are healthy there. But there's new life, new joy, new hope in their lives, because they can live a normal life like everybody else, and at the same time being cured and being wanted specially.
A significant achievement of yours, Mother, was the formation of the International Association of Co-workers. A word about their activities.
They number now 123,000 around the world, and their way is a way of life, which now they have to take care of the poor in their own family first, in the next door neighbor, and slowly in the whole world. But there is to radiate and to find the poor and to bring that joy, that peace, that understanding, love among the people whom they visit. Especially love begins at home.
Mother, your spontaneous reaction to the Nobel Prize was, "It's a gift of God, and I'll accept the honor, and we'll use it for His greater glory." It's a beautiful gift because they have recognized the presence of the poor in the world. Mother, what were your feelings when you were conferred the Bharat Ratna?
I think I'm most unworthy. And for the same reason, I accept it for the glory of God and for our people.
So humble of you to say that, Mother. But I think the whole world knows that you're worthy of such a reward. Before I conclude this interview, to quote you, "The worst disease in the world is the feeling of being unwanted." Would you like to elaborate, Mother?
Yes, because a plate of rice will not remove that hunger for love. And we are not hungry only for a piece of, hunger is not only for a piece of bread or for a plate of rice. There is hunger to be loved, to be wanted. And nakedness is not only for a piece of cloth, but nakedness is also that they have lost that human dignity, that human respect that is due to every human being. And homelessness is not only not having a home to live in, but all homelessness that we are rejected, that we are despised. And the poor know that being despised, being rejected by society, having been forgotten by the society, have been thrown away by the society, unwanted, unloved, uncared, is a great homelessness. And that's why our sisters are not only dealing with material poverty, but they are dealing with this spiritual poverty, which is much more difficult to remove. That's why we need very close union with God in prayer and sacrifice to be able to put this love of God and His compassion into a living action in the service of the poorest of the poor, our brothers and sisters who have been created for the same purpose, to love and to be loved. And so they become our own, our brothers and sisters.
Thank you, Mother.
Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you.
You are listening to an interview with Mother Teresa, the recipient of the Bharat Ratna and the Nobel Prize. She was interviewed by G.K. Marar. This broadcast came to you from the studios of All India Radio, Hyderabad.